Good evening, folks. Ashish Tata here. Welcome to another episode. I didn't work too long on this, but this will probably be more or less the look I'll go for. I'll make it more interesting by adding some stairs like this to have a bit more depth on the wall, because it's just a plain wall. I might end up doing mossy stone bricks and water running from the top of the mountain over it or something, I don't know. But yeah, you will see it. Another thing is I finally found a purpose for my silk touch shovel, since it's harvesting clay. Because usually I will craft the blocks, the clay balls back into blocks, because I can transport 4 times as much. So I'll do that now and do some exploring on the way, because I want to keep a healthy balance, and that's why we're gonna build over there some more houses. But I don't have any clay. I'm also running low on slime balls. So that's what I will do now, and if I find a witch hut or something, I'll show it to you guys. So, I found a witch hut and it's getting dark. I absolutely don't know what's the deal with witches. The only thing I know is that they throw potions. And they can drop redstone, as far as I know, which makes a farm relatively interesting. However, this is a few blocks away from my home. But yeah, I could connect it with another portal or something. Let's get away from there, see if one spawns. Waiting, I will kill some slimes and cut to the part where the witch spawns. Let's see what she attacks. Wow, they are weak. She dropped gunpowder. That poison doesn't kill me. Well, they hit quite hard, but 2 arrows. For the extremely low spawn rate and spawning space, it's doesn't seem balanced fair. Finally, we found the first village in this world, and it's extremely big. It seems like it's 2 houses big. Looks like a lot. So, farming clay got boring, so I stopped right here, although I wanted to fill the whole chest in my inventory. But yeah, it's 9 plus 7, 18, 16, 16 and a half stacks of clay. And that should be enough for a bunch of houses, a bunch of roofs. Also, I got 2 stacks of slime balls, a bunch of cacti, because I want to have the green dye at some point. Now we will put 30 levels into a bow, just because I don't have any diamonds left. And then I'll farm some clay and see you later up there. And smelt the clay, obviously. And some sticks. What's this ring there? Also got cat again. Let's see what we get. Punch 2, power 4, and flame 1. That's an awesome bow. Punch on a bow is not as bad as on a sword. So yeah, I'll farm some clay and see you in a bit. Obviously I already found the clay, but still need to make clay balls out of it. For some odd reason this doesn't work. Would be nice if it would. Another thing that would be neat was if you could make slime blocks. Like blocks from four slime balls. And they should act like jump pads in Quake or something. Or just be a bit bouncy so you can transport mobs 2 blocks up or 3, or transport yourself 3 blocks up if you run onto them and jump. Maybe if you don't jump, I don't know. Yeah, that's from just towering up once. So I got 17 levels from smelting, I believe. Pretty sure I was 4 before I started, and I'm not even halfway through the clay. But we got a bunch of bricks, and I'm out of coal. Let's take this. Do we have any glass left? Nope, but I think there's glass up there. So we'll just need a bunch of wood, which we'll get now. Then we can start building again. Let's just take this wood. Of course, if I need wood to continue this, I've got plenty here. Works quite good, actually. So, got plenty of wood, and before we start building into the mountain there, we will put some other houses on top of this mountain. And the reason for that is mainly because I need to get villagers from zombies. There's plenty of glass in there. A bunch of golden apples and potions of weakness here. In case I see one in the night while building a few houses. And yeah, that's the main reason. On top of here, I will have walkways. I need a crafting bench. And I usually do these with stone brick stairs, or I always did these with the stone brick stairs. But let me just tune down the sound here. Because I use stone brick stairs for these houses, which I never did because I use Dokocroft and their cobble actually looks good. I don't really want to use stone brick stairs for walkways. We will have our walkways like this. Yeah. Let's just get this one. Put it here. Maybe even one wider. But I guess for the most part it's gonna be like this. So, two wide actually. Three if you count the upper part from the stairs. Well, I made a rough estimate. I guess the first house, the first additional house, will be here, right in this corner. And contrary to this house, we won't have the pillars extended a block. Will not look as good from far away, but yeah, it takes up a lot of space building the houses like this. And it's absolutely okay for the outer houses, because you can extend them over the cliff like here and have as much space as you like. But I don't want... yeah, how to put this? I would love to have more than three houses on this mountain, or in the middle of the outer houses. So yeah, before I start, I will probably build the walkway here, finish it. So I have an estimate of the height stuff with the dirt blocks here, because this is not flat ground, and I will not make it flat ground. Yeah. So I guess we'll have the base here and terraform this a bit, so have it more or less flat, like up to here or something. So we will get rid of this. And let's have it. Yeah, this long. Good work. No zombies. Yeah, up here the knockback isn't too bad. Just throw them out of the range so they despawn. Then maybe get some zombies up here. And we'll probably terraform a bit here too. So I'll be like, this looks natural, pretty random. Yeah, I thought about making an episode on terraforming at some point, but I don't know. Because I actually can make things look natural, but I don't know how to explain it. There's really not much to say about it, other than yeah, make it look random, more or less, but not messy. Door is gonna be around there. I can just get a four-wide window here. Two-wide windows here. I guess I'll do a second story, so we're just gonna have one wide window here. We'll have oak wood around the door. We have that there too. No. But here we will have it. And I'm not sure if this looks good. I was always annoyed by doing the walkways with regular wooden logs, because when you go through here and look up, it just looks bad, but the sideways logs, I don't know. Maybe if we have it like this. Yeah, that might work. I'm not sure what we will have on top. We'll just try out stone bricks. Should use another material like sandstone. Or regular bricks if the roof isn't made from bricks. And that does look good indeed. But we'll try it like this. Do we have fences down there? I don't know. That sucks. We'd have a look here. And this is how we will add some depth to the building here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we need to use something else. But we can do that later, because I don't feel like running to my storage now. Maybe we should use darker planks. But we'll just finish this, because... Yeah, we'll just finish it, because... I don't know. I'm changing it to something different later. It's gonna be quite easy. Because then you have the basic shape and just need to exchange blocks one after another, which is relatively fast. Yeah, let's try it with these planks now. Ignore the dirt and you'll see that this looks outright terrible. Spruce wood planks don't go at all with the oak wood. It blends in too much, not enough contrast. So we might use dark wood for all this stuff. Or maybe birch. I want to try it with birch. Yeah, looks like a zebra on acid. I won't do that. Well, I will at some point, but not with this style of house. This looks terrible. And that looks okay, but I re-add the line at the top. Or I end up using something different for the line on the top. Maybe sandstone. And let's just try it with these oak blocks. Let's exchange the door here. Forgot that. I think I will go with this look for now. Yeah, birch wood looks too bright with the sandstone. This looks fine, I think. Well, it's not perfect, but it will do for now. I'm okay with the looks. Might be not enough contrast with the oak logs. So maybe I will exchange them with these spruce logs, although I really don't like this. Yeah, I finished the roof on the other house. And I guess we will end the episode with another enchantment. On the ball again. So, let's put another 30 levels into a bow. Because the last episode we didn't have an enchantment. And yeah, it's pretty much okay, I guess. And there goes our wheat farm. Yeah. So, goodbye, thanks for watching. And yeah, I don't know. Have a good sleep or whatever you do now. And next episode, I don't know what we will do.